Welcome to Clinton Journal. I'm Bob Cannon, your Township Supervisor, and today we're going to talk about something that's good for all homeowners and business owners in Clinton Township. And first I'm going to talk about our fire department, because that's why there is some good news. Our fire department has done a fabulous job through the years, and they're doing even a better job today. There are more runs, there are more emergency runs, there are more calls for service than ever before, and our staff has been well-trained and has great equipment, and we're going to talk about how your insurance rates are probably going to be going down. I have with me today our fire chief, Tim Duncan. And Tim, tell us a little bit about why we're looking at a reduction in our insurance rates throughout Clinton Township.
Okay, we're pretty happy to announce that we're going to be dropping our classification was at a 4. We just got notice recently that we're going to be dropping down to a 3. Basically what that entails is essentially a report card for local communities. ISO, which is the Insurance Service Office, provides a ability to come in to evaluate fire departments throughout the nation. I believe they're doing something like about 45,000 different departments nationally. And then they come in and evaluate different parts of the community, whether it be the water service and fire protection services.
So the lower the number, the better.
Yes.
And that's how your insurance rate is evaluated when you go to pay for your homeowner's insurance.
Yes. Yes, they evaluate you on a classification level of a 1 being the best to a 9. And we being a 3 puts us in the top 5,000 out of about those 45,000 departments throughout the country, which is a little bit above the 90%
So you're at a pretty elite level.
Yes, yes.
And we're telling our homeowners today, because are they the ones who need to notify their insurance agent, or does it automatically appear and your rates are going to go down automatically?
It should automatically appear. Our effective date for the change will be September 1st of this year. And ISO will publicize that to the local communities and the agents. So if I would advise business owner or resident of the community to reach out to their agent just to be sure that they have the most up-to-date information on that.
So you had a 4, which is probably pretty good. Probably put you in the top 25% anyway, but now you're even higher up. How did you go from a 4 to a 3, Tim?
Well, I think a lot of it has to credit to all the departments throughout the township. The township board kind of, very given us the tools and the ability to hire really the best people in the region to be members of our department. The water department's done an excellent job on keeping the water system pretty much top-notch. That's probably one of the biggest parts of the puzzle. And with our billing department and our prevention department, basically just getting aggressively after the buildings that cause some problems. Really opening the fifth station, and probably the biggest part recently has been the changeover to the county dispatching that got us maximum points this time around. So I think that kind of put us over the top to get down to the 3, because we're just way more efficient on getting our apparatus there quickly.
And I know your background, and I know how you are. You're not going to be satisfied with the 3 forever.
No. We've already started tearing apart the report. We feel pretty confident within the next year or so that we can get that drop to a 2. We're exceptionally close this time. Kind of disappointed that we didn't get there, but we think we have the ability pretty easily to change that and hopefully get it down to a 2. By their standard, you have to wait at least a full year before you can reapply, so we're looking towards that right now.
And you made a promise, you and your staff made a promise to the community, that if they passed a millage in 2013, that you were going to have a staffing level of what you are at today, and you were going to have the equipment as to what you are today, and you were going to have, as important, the training that you have today to provide the protection in our community. And you've added things on your rigs now that are saving lives every single day.
Oh, for sure, yeah. We're proud to announce, you'll probably see it in the next few days to week. The new fire truck has arrived. We're in the process of outfitting that and getting everything done for it. Local community groups, the Kiwanis and Barrymore's and a few others, giving us the Lucas CPR device, which now we're gonna have our fourth one coming soon, and we should have the fifth one by the end of the year, which will probably put us at the top of the state as far as providing that type of equipment.
I saw it in operation. It was fantastic. Another great tool for your staff.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, we couldn't be happier than we are with that, and what a great outpouring from even just certain individuals that are stepping forward to help us out.
It was, I had tears in my eyes at our last board meeting when a woman came up and gave us a check for $16,000 out of her pocket so you could buy your fifth one.
Yeah, and it means a lot to her, because Really the relationship that our firefighters developed with her family. Her husband was in need over the past 6 months, and just the outpouring and the care that they provided really spoke to her, and she was more than happy to do it. She made the comment coming out of the softball game that one day that she was going to make it happen, and I couldn't believe how fast she did.
She came right up there. It really choked us up.
Yeah.
Now, you have something else that we're doing now, too. Are you going to be part of that hockey game that's coming up, the fundraiser?
We actually just received that notification yesterday. Our group is certainly going to be part of that. I think it's going to end up being the police versus firefighters hockey 2.0 version of the softball game. And, it's, disappointing that we had to do it for this reason, but we want to do everything possible to help the young man out and move forward with our police department to do something very valuable.
One of our police officers, a very good police officer, his son came down with a rare form of cancer, and the fundraiser is going to be for the extra funds that the family needs to get him to and from some of the treatments. He's got to take a year off of college just to start the treatments, and that's a big blow right there. But Tom Holloway, he's the liaison officer at the high school, Chippewa Valley High School. He's been on the road. He's been a union president. He's just been a real stable, wonderful man in the community, and this is just a devastating blow to him and his family.
Yeah, and it's pretty much what our department has looked to do over the last few years, actually prior during our whole history, is sometimes you forget about the issues that the parents have. They're going to have to take off work for an extended amount of time. So our group tends to want to give some of that money back to help those people get over that hump of missing some time from work and being with their child, more on a full-time
right.
basis while this is going on.
And that's the other thing your staff has done forever, and even more so now. When there's a need in the community that is not being met, you meet it. You do fundraisers, you do golf outings, you do other things, and you put that money 100% plus back into the basically youth of our community. So thank you for that.
Sure.
And your guys are just showing another side to them that makes them superior.
Yeah.
And the hockey game will be fun. Now, you're kind of basking in the glory of two softball wins over the police department.
Yep.
So are you kind of giving a prediction on the hockey game coming up?
We've got some good players, so I'm not really sure how what the police bring on the hockey side, but it's going to be a good battle. Some of our younger people are exceptional athletes, so it should
be a good
battle.
And it is nice to see your guys walking around with your muscles, because you need those muscles on a daily basis.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, it's a lot more. Everything on all sides of work is becoming more demanding, so it's a nice thing that we have the ability to keep them fit on a day-to-day basis.
So really, two messages today. Your insurance rates are going to go down. The chief is going to work with the staff to get them to go down even further next year. And we have this fundraiser coming up where the police and fire departments are going to play hockey against each other. It's $10 to get in. It'll be at the Fraser Hockeyland. You can read about it on the screen. Please come out and support not only the guys, but for the young man who's going to benefit with the money received for the hockey game. Tim, anything else you want to add?
No, just that, once again, we appreciate the support. We're happy to be able to bring this news to the community. Anytime anybody's got any questions, anything, reach out to us. We're always available by email, phone call, anytime.
You've got a great staff. We love having you here. Thank you for the good news for all of us here in Clinton Township.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching Clinton Journal. I'm Bob Cannon, your Township Supervisor.